Hey loves! So I decided to do a cleanse, and my cleanse is pretty much a blend of plant-based eating, where you eat fully raw, fresh fruits, fresh vegetables, smoothies for meals, where you blend delicious smoothies and you have them for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and a lot of water, a lot of water. And that's the type of cleanse that I've been doing. I did it for a total of 10 days and I filmed a majority of that for you so that you can see what my weigh-ins were like and how much weight I lost on a daily basis. I wanted to be really transparent and I opened up myself for you all to see visually what my weigh-ins are. I already do weigh-ins socially on Instagram, on my Healthy Janelle platform already as it is. So I felt like if I just filmed the weigh-ins, it would take it up a notch so you could actually see day by day by day progression. So stay tuned to see how that was. Alright, so it is the end of my cleanse. Today is officially the last day. And for those of you who are looking to do something that will help jumpstart your body, because once you do a cleanse and you detox your body of toxins and all of those things that are harboring in your system and just staying there and, you know, not making you as successful at weight loss as you want to, I highly encourage you to do some research on your own, figure out what it is that you can do and build it into your lifestyle. There's so many things out there that help to cleanse your body and detox your body. So there's so many opportunities for you to figure it out. Of course, if you want to talk to me a little bit more in detail, I do offer consultations. They're not free, so you probably want to do the research on your own. But if you want to take that one-on-one time with me, absolutely, you can email me. My email will be below. But just to give you some final thoughts about the entire cleanse, I'm so happy that I did it. I'm happy that I committed to it because I've done cleanses before that were a little bit shorter, but to do one for a full 10 days really, really has changed the way I feel. Cleanses usually get rid of toxins and you will notice that you don't have as much bloating. That is a number one thing that I can say that I absolutely feel. I don't feel bloated throughout the entire day, not ever. Another thing for me I noticed before is I was very gassy often. Depending on what I was eating, depending on the time of the day, I was gassy, always passing gas. And I've hardly passed gas at all this past 10 days. There was a few days where I had some rumbling, but it was clear indication that a bowel movement was near. Whereas before, there was just lots of flatulence with no end in sight. And so that is the second thing that I've noticed tremendously. A third thing, I used to have a sweet tooth and would want to eat some type of like processed carbohydrate, like a cake or a cupcake or some praline wafers or something sweet and hearty like popcorn. And I would eat it in moderation, which was a healthy choice, of course, but I always needed it, which is what I'm getting at, is I always needed it. And I've not needed it since I would say maybe day number four. Days 1, 2, and 3, absolutely, I'm still getting in the gist of the whole cleanse thing and I'm still navigating myself through it. not really as on board with it physically and emotionally as I was mentally, because I was in it to win it. But physically and emotionally, day three is really hard, really challenging. But by day four, I could care less. I've not missed sweets as much. I do have moments where, because it was habitual, where I start thinking, let me go. And I'm like, no, you're on a cleanse, you can't. And that easily pulls me back in, like, Janelle, take it easy. After, I would say, day five, or maybe it was also day four. Maybe day four was a pivotal moment for me in my cleanse. After day four, I hit a point where I actually stopped feeling hungry. And I mentioned in a previous video, my Janelle Bookshelf December book, that I've been reading this book by Marco Borges. If you want more information, check out my December Janelle Bookshelf. I'll link it below or here somewhere. I'm reading that book and it's talking a lot about plant-based, which is pretty much what you have to follow. I've been following on the cleanse that I'm doing. It's all plant-based. So it was really helpful reading it and getting more insight and understanding as to why plant-based is good for you and just reminding myself about it. I'm not a nutritionist. I didn't go to school for this. So easily, it's easy to forget when you say, oh, fruits and vegetables are healthy. Yes, we know. But reminding myself about the specifics of why they're so good for you and why whole grains is so good for you and so on. So I've been reading that, and he talks a lot about habits and the habit of overeating and overindulging. And when you're on a cleanse, because you're limiting your caloric intake and also quantity of food, you often will feel extremely hungry. But I think reading this book and putting it into perspective, that there is a point where you eat, or when you are eating, where you are 100% satisfied. But because you served yourself a certain amount, even if it's a healthy portion, because I always measure, you still keep going because you know you can. I had goals in place for this cleanse. And so reading that put me at a place where it was like, okay, so what if you're eating an apple? If you get a quarter way through the apple and you find that you're not hungry anymore, save the other 75% for when you're hungry. You don't have to eat the whole apple just because you decided you were going to eat an apple. And that really changed it for me. And since that day, I've found myself more aware and more conscious of when I'm satisfied and not feeling hungry. My stomach, there's only been one day during this entire process where my stomach growled. There's been times I've been hungry, but it didn't growl at all. Whereas in the past, my stomach was always growling. So the restriction of a cleanse, the caloric restriction of my cleanse afforded me a great opportunity to lose a lot of weight. A portion of the weight obviously was because I did overindulge on vacation, so my body was just coming back down to normal. But I've passed that normal. And when I hit that place, you could see that my weight loss was a lot more gradual than it was in the beginning. In the beginning, it was like, boom, you lost all this weight because it was just salt, you know, excess water retention and things like that. So I'm really happy. It's pushed me forward. I guess I can kind of declare it now, but I've decided that I'm going to go vegetarian. I don't know how many days you need to not eat meat before you can say I'm a vegetarian, but I was a vegetarian before for about 3.5 years. I introduced seafood back into my diet and did that for a whole nother year where I was pescatarian. And then I had my son and my daughter thereafter, and I've been eating meat for about 4 years now again. So I started going off on a tangent, but the information was just so good that I'm going to make it a separate video. Subscribe for instant notifications. I love you for watching. Bye.